Hello, and welcome to Chemistry in Your Cupboard. My name is Ross, and I'm an Education Coordinator for the Royal Society of Chemistry. Today, we're looking at using separation techniques to try and clean up some water. This is an activity you can try with a responsible adult. So let's get started. For this experiment, we need a colander, a sieve, some muslin or cheesecloth, large bowls, some water, and some things to mix into our water. I have rocks, rice and dirt. We're going to look at how we can separate this mixture of solids and liquids using different techniques. This water has all of our solids mixed into the water. You can see there's some rocks, some dirt and some rice in there. So let's see if we can separate this mixture using our colander. Okay, so we've caught all of our rocks and a lot of the rice. So we'll just shake that around to see if anything falls through the gaps. Okay, that's everything. So now we've still got dirt in the water and some bits of rice as well. Okay, let's try something with smaller holes in it, the sieve this time. So we'll pour that through. Okay, so the water all went through. Now we've caught a lot more rice and some of the dirt this time, some of the bigger pieces of dirt, they wouldn't fit through the holes. But we'll have a look at the water now, and we can see there's still some dirt left at the bottom. So finally, we're going to try our cheesecloth. So this is a cheesecloth or a muslin. It's a material with really tiny little holes in it, so we'll see how this one goes. Okay, so it takes a bit longer for the water to get through because we've got much smaller holes, but we can see a lot of dirt caught in our white cheesecloth, and we'll pull that away. You can see the water coming out is way, way clearer. It's so much more clear now as well. Now remember, this water isn't clean. There will still be tiny bits of dirt floating in there that we do not want to drink. People separate things all the time. You may rinse your rice or your lentils to remove any sand or dust, and your grown-up may use a tea bag to make sure that the tea leaves are separate from their tea itself. But what's really important is to make sure that you choose the right tool for the right job. Now that we've seen some of our different techniques for removing different sized solids from water, over to you. With a responsible adult, what's the smallest thing that you can remove from water? Share your results with us using the hashtag ChemistryInYourCupboard, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel to see more Chemistry in Your Cupboard videos coming soon. Thank you very much for watching.